Alastair Campbell, former communications director for Tony Blair, joins me now. You heard what Angela Merkel, the German chancellor, had to say, and you said she's being what?
I think she's being fair and reasonable.
Okay.
At a time when she and other European leaders must be looking at Britain and thinking, they don't really deserve fairness and reasonableness at the moment, but I'm pretty glad she's there.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we're in a mess. We're in a complete and total mess.
How do you get yourself out of it? Is there a path out of it?
There's no clear path at the moment because there's a leadership vacuum. I mean, David Cameron is humiliating for him to have to go and do what he's done today, but at least he's doing it. George Osborne's trying to kind of stabilise the economy. But you've got a situation here, and this is what's so awful about this, where David Cameron essentially has been toppled. The people who've done it have now gone to ground. They're off running their little leadership games and trying to get ready for that. Boris Johnson, I think, is showing himself with every hour that passes utterly unfit for any serious job, certainly unfit to be Prime Minister. And now we're in this amazing position where this campaign, having been all about we ought to be able to elect our leaders, and the next Prime Minister is going to be picked by this shrinking, aging, little
but
group of people.
Is this? David Cameron put this country through this?
Of course it is.
He didn't have to promise a referendum,
no,
yet he did for political reasons.
Correct.
But on both sides as well, the Labour Party, Jeremy Corbyn, many of his MPs say he was at best not in a not very motivated way campaigning for the Remain side.
At best. Well, listen, I've written a piece on my website today about leadership and the total lack of it. Cameron, as you say, we did not need this referendum. He should have seen it off in argument. He did it, as you say, as a tactic to deal with the rise of UKIP at a certain point in time. And referendums are never about what's on the ballot paper. They're always about all sorts of different things. Boris Johnson, I say, has gone to ground. Jeremy Corbyn just had a vote of confidence in the Parliamentary Labour Party. Mm-hmm. Hardly anybody wants him. He's now driving the Labour Party off a cliff. I mean, we're becoming a joke.
More than half of British voters want to leave the EU. That is their will. That is what they want.
Yeah.
That was the result of a democratic process in the form of a referendum.
It was.
So now what?
Well, I do think, I mean, I'm in a bit of a minority here in that, yes, you have to accept the democratically expressed will of the people. But I am meeting so many people who voted leave and who are telling me they had no idea this was going to happen.
But that's their fault. You inform
yourself.
Well,
maybe. But
everyone has the internet now.
Just
look it up.
Okay, but that place, Parliament and parliamentary democracy, Boris Johnson and his campaign, they went into that campaign literally on a pack of lies.
Mm-hmm.
A pack of lies without a plan. And we've seen the lies, and they worked, and we've now seen there's no plan.
Okay, well, some of the figures might have been exaggerated figures.
No, they weren't exaggerated, they were lies.
But the fears that were stoked in people were real fears.
Correct.
Many people in some of the more deprived, economically deprived area felt like some of these EU migrants were taking their jobs, putting pressure on schools, on hospitals, bringing down wages.
Correct.
Were they all wrong to think that?
That is all true. The question, though, is whether the right way to deal with that is coming out of the European Union.
And is it?
No, of course it's not. We've had that argument and we've lost that argument.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying to you, look, this is the great irony. Just as Donald Trump in America has somehow, and one of the greatest cons of all time, being able to colonise the voice of the working man in America, Boris Johnson, old Etonian, Oxbridge, Daily Telegraph, Tory MP, has got blue-collar workers
making
him Prime Minister.
Is that a failure of the establishment, though, of not having responded for decades, not just the last few governments?
For decades, this establishment, real concerns
of how globalization has hurt ordinary workers.
Absolutely, it is, But the point is,
So there's enough blame to go around, is what I'm
saying. Listen, nobody's covered themselves in glory on this one, okay? My point is that, and this is why referendums, I mean, I said this the day after the last general election. I was on BBC Question Time. Mm-hmm. The first question was, will Britain leave the European Union? And I said, I hope not, because I hope the British people will save the politicians from themselves. And I said then, and I was howled down for being anti-democratic, referendums are dangerous in a parliamentary democracy.
Why is that?
Because we've had a referendum in one of the most ill-informed, lying debates that I can ever recall anywhere in the world. We've been like a banana republic in the last few days. This has been a joke, this referendum, in so many ways.
Are you afraid that now this country will break up, that Scotland will choose to secede?
Yes.
And this is the end, really, of Great Britain or the United Kingdom.
I'm afraid of lots of things. I'm afraid and appalled at the horrible racism that's been unleashed. Every single day, I've been bumping into people who are saying things that have been happening to them. Taxi drivers, mm-hmm. who, because they're not white and they're not British, even though lots of them are, they're getting abuse. Mm-hmm. There's some horrible stuff on the internet. A thing in Manchester yesterday of this black guy on a bus being abused and taunted. Last night on Channel 4, England football fans singing, if you all hate Muslims, clap your hands. That has been unleashed by this referendum. Mm-hmm. And yes, I can blame horrible right-wing newspapers that we have in this country. But
in the end,
The Mail, The Express, The Star, they've been pumping this drum for months and years. But in the end, it only worked because mainstream politicians gave voice to it. Boris Johnson and Michael Gove in particular. They should be ashamed. They should be utterly ashamed. They should be out there now condemning it, because it is people who supported them who are now doing this.
Well, one of those two men might be your next prime minister.
Well, if he is, then I, for one, will be utterly ashamed to be British, and I will almost certainly go and live in Scotland, where at least you've got decent people, a pretty strong leader at the helm, and a proper political debate going on, unlike the nonsense that's going on now with a joke government and a joke Labour Party leadership.
Alastair Campbell, strong words. I can tell you're very upset.
I'm really angry at what's happened, because mm-hmm. none of it needed to happen. Yes, you're right, the immigration issue had to be tackled.
Yeah.
But not with this. And this is a catastrophe that's been unleashed on Britain. We're a joke.